Yes, good afternoon, everyone. It's good to see such a good, great turnout this afternoon. In fact, I was told by my staff that some of you actually haven't heard of Viva Industrial Trust. So it gave me great pleasure to share with you something that you may have missed. So these are the content that I'm going to go through this afternoon. Just to give you an overview of the Viva Industrial Trust, in short VIT, we only listed in November 2013, so to now is about 1.5 years. And we are slightly different from other industrial REIT in a sense that we are a staple group. And why is this staple group? Because we have a very rare, unique integrated development that consists of a business park as well as a hotel. And because of a hotel, we will need to structure something similar to other hotel REIT, where we have a business trust stapled to this REIT. So if you were to go to SGS website, you probably can't find our name under the REIT because of this structure. But in fact, effectively, we actually no different from other industrial REIT. The current market cap is about 511 million as at May 2015. We focuses on investing quality industrial estate, as you probably can we'll share with you later. Currently, we have 5 quality properties with 16 buildings, value at about 852 million. The total GFA is about 2.9 million square feet. And because of the quality asset that we have, we are able to attract a lot of MNC as well as GLC. And they account for about 76.2% of the underlying gross rental income. So why should you as an investor invest in VIT? Firstly, we have a diversified portfolio of quality asset. And not only we have the quality asset, we are actually offering a very attractive yield of more than 9% currently. And because of the quality asset we have, as I mentioned, we have more than 76% of the tenants are actually coming from MNC as well as GLC. The portfolio also provide stable income with embedded growth. Some of the properties are either on master lease or long leases with a lot of MNC. So that provide a staggered lease expiry and provide a stability of income for the portfolio. We also have a strong cornerstone and strategic partner as well as sponsor support. Unlike typical single sponsor REIT, we are able to reach out to 2 sponsors as well as his strategic partners, which is Shanghai Summit, Mr. Tong, and I believe some of you all probably have heard his name. He's actually invested in quite many REIT in Singapore. And lastly, of course, we also have an experienced team of management team within VIT. Myself, I was the co-founder for Cambridge Industrial Trust. During those days, I put together 27 property and was listed in 2006. I grew the portfolio size from about 520 million to close to 1 billion before I left in early 2009. Okay, this is the first Q result. We have quite a good set of financial result for first Q this year. Both the gross revenue and distributable income has grown by 20.8% and 13.4% respectively. The distribution per stapled securities has also increased by 8.6%, and that translates to a very attractive annualized distribution yield of 9.4% based on the closing price of 80.5 cents as at end of March. Currently, we are focusing on one of the assets, which is a Technopark at Chai Chi we bought from CapitaLand during the IPO. And because of the rezoning that back in 2008, so I will share with you later what we are doing. So currently, we already have the provisional permission from URA. So we are likely to start to commence the A&As within this quarter. So we are breaking into 2 phases. So the first phase should complete, targeting to complete by end of the year. And then the second phase should complete by middle of next year. And for this AEI, we have actually secured a very good anchor tenant. I'm not sure some of you have heard the name before. It's one of the global sport retail giant, Decathlon. I think it could be quite new for a lot of Singaporeans, but they are quite big in Europe and has been expanding very fast in China. So in Singapore, this will be their first flagship store for the Southeast Asia, occupying about 35,000 square feet. So to share with you what we have within the portfolio, as you can see from this map, other than the logistic asset located in the west, which is in close proximity to Second Link and Jurong Port, the other four properties are very well located in the key business park as well as established industrial cluster. Most of all of them actually is within walking distance to the train station, MRT station, and well connected to highway, so it's highly accessible. So this will ensure the long-term visibility of the asset. Okay, the portfolio consists of five quality asset with the total GFA of 2.9 million square feet and a total portfolio value of 852 million. Four out of five properties are relatively new, so we have the weighted average age of building of about 7.6 years. The portfolio also have a relatively long weighted average land lease expiry of 40.6 years relative to other industrial REIT. And as you can see from the chart there, we have actually got high proportion of a business park, which is the best asset class within the industrial sectors. And that account for 66.8% of the value portfolio value. Okay, let's zoom into the strength of each property. If you have been to Changi Business Park, I think you probably have seen this property. We have the NTUC hypermarket there. UEB's Hub East is a very rare integrated development located at the heart of Changi Business Park. It consists of a business park and a retail F&B as well as the hotel. So this is a very unique integrated mixed-use business park development that provides convenient access to retail F&B, hotel accommodation, as well as the MICE facilities. Within the business park component, we have two towers and a retail podium. The location is very good in the sense that it's just a stone throw away from the existing expo station. And currently, you may see, if you have been there, you probably see a lot of hoarding around because they are currently building the downtown line station, which target to complete by 2017. So eventually when that happens, we will have a direct link from the basement of this project. So that will provide a much better access. And you probably be aware that it's quite rare to have a industrial or business park access that are served by two lines. So we expect a lot of vibrancy once that is done. The property also was awarded the Green Mark Gold Plus for their green initiative. And you know, a lot of MNC are treating such certification as an important criteria when they are choosing for their choice business location. For the hotel component, part of the UEB Hub East, it consists of a 251 room hotel room, 30 service offices, 5 retail units, as well as the convention center that can accommodate about 700 pax. As you can see from the picture, the round one, that's the convention center we have. The hotel is leased to United Engineers effectively for 10 years, and they manage that under their Park Avenue brand, which they also have other hotel and service apartment in Singapore and in the region. Okay, the second property is Technopark Chai Chee. This previously was positioned more like a high-tech development. And it consists of a 6 block, high-tech block equipped with lifestyle amenities. It's again strategically located between two train stations. One of it is Kemangan, the other one is Bedok MRT station. The nearby Bedok Town Center does provide a ready supporting amenity to the tenants. Because of the rezoning back in 2008, and it allowed us, because under it was rezoned to business park back in 2008, and under business park zoning, we are allowed to have up to 15% of the GFA for white, and that's why we are taking this opportunity to look at asset enhancement to convert about 226,000 square feet of GFA to white, which I have a bit more detail to share with you later. The next property is a logistic property located in Tuas area. This is quite a new property as well, completed in 2012. It's a two-story ramp up, so the ramp up feature does allow container access to upper level, so thereby increasing the operational efficiency for the logistic operators. And from the trust perspective, it does reduce the long-term maintenance costs as well. The location will also benefit from the consolidation of the container port, which is very close to this location in Tuas area in time to come. The next two properties are Jackson Square and Jackson Design Hub. These are the two properties that we acquired last year. Again, they are very well located. For Jackson Square, it's within short walking distance to Braddell MRT station, located in the densely populated Toa Payoh area. So it's very leasable, I mean highly leasable for long term. The other property, Jackson Design Hub, this is located in Paya Lebar I-Park, location that's been master planned by JTC as the industrial park for 21st century. So for some of you all been there, you probably be to this Breadtalk building where you can, you know, enjoy some of the F&B there, you know, the Ding Tai Fung and some of the ramen restaurant there as well. The Tai Seng MRT station is actually very nearby. It's currently what happens is that there's a plot of development that's undergoing development, and they are undertaking a construction to build underground tunnel that link to the Tai Seng station. So in a year's time or so, you'll be, you know, from this property, it will take about 1-2 minutes just to access to the train station. So within the portfolio, as you can see from this chart, we have a high quality of tenant mix with very strong tenant covenants. We have a very strong tenant name such as Cisco System, McNerbert, OneNet. OneNet is actually a MediaCorp data center. So we have actually quite a few data center tenants within the portfolio as well. We have the NTUC FairPrice, which is operating the Hypermark in the UEB Sub East. Johnson Control, British Telecom. So these are very good MNC name and GLC name that we have within the portfolio. The top 10 tenant only account for about 49.6% of the monthly committed rental. The portfolio also enjoys a diverse mix of more than 100 tenants. So we are also quite well diversified in terms of the tenant base. And they come from various trade sectors, such as e-business data center, in packaging, energy, lifestyle, electronic, general engineering, as well as information and communication technology. This is one of the key sectors that has been powering Singapore economic growth, and it accounts for 36.4% of the underlying gross income. And as we shared earlier, majority of the tenants are either MNC or GLC, so they account for more than 76% of the gross rental income. The underlying leases of our properties are typically for 3+3 years, but certain key tenants such as you know, Cisco System, NTUC, FairPrice, Mauser, they do have a longer lease term of 5 years or more. So such long-term leases with staggered lease expiry does provide income stability to the portfolio. Bearing in mind that this chart doesn't take into account the renewal option that was that's been granted to the tenants. And for industrial tenant, what happens, it tend to be more sticky in the sense that when they come in, they usually spend quite a huge capex to fit up the place, and then they're likely to be renewal for many terms to come, unless they were grown out of the place or they are closing down their business. Okay, this is an AEI project that we are very excited about because it will help provide a big booster to our income. Because of the rezoning, we are looking at about converting about close to 15% of the GFA to white. So when we white, we could talk about, you know, converting it to retail F&B and supermarket and together with some enrichment and education related activities. So we have actually got the provisional permission to convert about 226,000 square feet to white. And there'll be two phases. The first phase we are looking at completing by end of this year, and then the second phase by middle of next year. There are a lot of benefit that we look at for this enhancement, because enhancement will be able to provide better amenities to serve both the Technopark, the current tenants, as well as the community. It will enhance the tenancy profile with the repositioning of this project from high-tech to a business park. It will also enhance the energy efficiency and contribute to a greener environment. And of course, we look at greater tenant retention as well as rental reversion. Ultimately, I think we are looking at enhancing the capital value as well as the return to increase the return to the investor as well. Okay, this is a site plan of Technopark at Chai Chee. As you can see, it's surrounded by HDB estate. And across the new Upper Changi Road is a big landed housing estate, which is Opera housing estate. Not too far away, like Lingkong area, I think they can also find a lot of condominium as well. So there's actually a big catchment that we are actually providing for this the tenant that we are bringing in. This is just a perspective that of Technopark Chai Chee post AEI. So there are three blocks that will be involved in this enhancement. The block O, which is a 750, we are actually converting the ground floor space together with part of a car park to bring in retail and the supermarket F&B as well as the supermarket to serve the tenant and the residents. Block A is the one that is fronting the main road. So the Catalan, which is already signed up the lease, will be taking the whole of ground floor currently being used for car park. So we actually trying to optimize the area which are leasable, converting the car park to a more leasable and add a lot more value to the portfolio. Block B will be the one that we are actually focusing on education, as well as the some sport-related activities. This is another perspective of the project post-AEI. As you can see, we are introducing a lot more vibrancy to the developments to make the place more attractive to the, both the current as well as the future tenants. This is the block B that we talk about focusing on education and enrichment and as well as the sport-related tenants. Okay, we have actually talked about this Decathlon. I think if you have time, you can actually surf their website. Currently, they are already in Singapore, but on an online basis. So they are looking at setting up this first flagship store in Technopark Chai Chee, occupying about 35,000 square feet. And the other tenant we have is Our Cafe. So they are setting up a third of its kind drive-through concept with Asian dining facilities. So currently, we are also in active talk with quite many tenants. So we expect to share more information with you going forward. Okay, this is just some financial numbers for our first Q results. As you can see, I think both the gross revenue as well as the net property incomes has exceeded forecasts by 22% and 27% respectively. And the distribution per stable security as well as the distributable income has also increased by about 12.5%. So that translates to annualized distribution yield of 9.4% based on the closing price of 80.5 cents as at the end of March. Our quarterly net property income, as you can see from the chart, has been steady and exceeding forecast for most of the quarters. The distribution since IPO has also been stable, and we have a significant outperformance of the forecast in the first Q this year because of the acquisition that we have for the two Jackson properties that is contributing, seeing the full effect in this quarter. So, as an investor, what is the total return if you were to invest in REIT since IPO? So you can see the end of first Q 2015, if you were to invest in REIT since IPO, you have gotten the total return of 15.7%. And that comprises a cumulative distribution of 9.78 cents, as well as the price appreciation of 2.5 cents from 78 cents at IPO to 80.5 cents at the close of end of March. Even at the closing price of 82 cents on Friday, we are still offering a very attractive yield of 9.2%. So if we look at the kind of quality asset we have, the kind of tenants, we should be actually trading to closer to maybe less than 8%. I mean, so that's something that maybe you can look into it. So at 9.4 distribution yield based on the closing price as at end of March, REIT presents a very attractive investment proposition with a spread of 7.1% over the 10-year Singapore government bond, as well as 9.1% over the 12-month fixed deposit. So it does, you know, give a good return to the investors. And bear in mind that all the current assets are all in Singapore, so we don't have the foreign exchange risk. In terms of capital management, our current borrowing stands at 385 million, and that translates to a gearing ratio of 43.4%, with an all-in borrowing cost of 3.83%. There is no refinancing due till end of next year, and we have actually fixed the interest rate for 85.7% of our outstanding borrowing. The interest coverage is also healthy at 4.7% relative to the typical loan covenant of 2.5%. So going forward, what's the outlook for Singapore? I think the economy, suppose you read the news, is expected to be stable for this year. On the industrial sectors, some of you probably have read that, you know, there's some oversupply of industrial properties, but I think that actually is quite different in a sense that those are actually more for the strata development, as you can see in Ubi and some of the area. What happened is that over the last few years, government has released some land, industrial land, and then a lot of them are being picked up by developer. So they break into strata units, 1,000-2,000 square feet, and then, you know, hoping that some of the investor will come in and buy for investment. But it turned out to be a disappointment for them because a lot of supplies are coming out at this point in time. But if you look at our asset, we're actually focusing more on bigger asset, business park especially. So we're actually targeting at more of the MNC tenant, typically looking at least 10,000-20,000 square feet of size. So it doesn't make sense for them to go to a five owner to combine some space for them. So there's actually not much competition in a sense. And according to analysts, the occupancy for business park, especially since we are actually focusing a lot on business park, has actually improved over the last first 3 months of this year. And in view of that, the rental for business park as well as the high-tech developments are expected to improve as well or strengthen based on the trend that we are seeing. At the BIT front, we will continue to look at diversifying our funding sources and focusing on the enhancement that we are currently embarking, because that's going to, like I say, provide a lot of kicker to the income, boost the income for the whole portfolio. Other than the organic growth, we will also be focusing on acquisition growth, whether it's in Singapore or outside Singapore, but those property must be able to add value to the portfolio so that we can actually deliver a good return to the investors. So with that, I end today's presentation. I understand there's no time for Q&A, but I'll be available at the booth, so if you want to ask further questions, please feel free to drop by. Thank you.